Warhol's Marilyn Monroe becomes the most expensive piece of 20th century art. This is News Review from BBC Learning English. Hello, I'm Rob, and joining me to talk about the language behind this story is Neil. Hello, Neil.
Hi, Rob. Hi, everyone. If you want to test yourself on the vocabulary, there's a quiz on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. But now let's hear more about this story from this BBC news report.
Andy Warhol created the 40-inch by 40-inch painting of Marilyn Monroe after her death using a promotional photo from one of her films. Christie's called it Warhol's ultimate depiction of his ultimate muse, a Mona Lisa for the 20th century.
So a portrait of Marilyn Monroe by the American pop artist Andy Warhol has set a world record. It was auctioned and sold for over $195 million, and that makes it the most expensive piece of 20th century art ever sold.
And you've chosen three words from news headlines about this story, haven't you? What are they, please?
I have, yes. We have iconic, fetches, and enthral.
That's iconic, fetches, and enthral. Okay, let's look at the first headline then, please.
So the first headline comes from The Guardian in the UK, and it is Andy Warhol's iconic Marilyn Monroe portrait sells for record $195 million.
So that's iconic, very famous, represents an idea.
That's right, yes. And this word iconic is an adjective. But it's helpful if we break it down and look at that first part, icon. Now, we see the word icon in a couple of contexts, don't we, Rob? Can you tell us?
Yeah, so we've got the religious idea, something that people perhaps look up to or worship. And then you've got that little thing on your computer, an icon that you click on.
That's right, yeah. And the thing that connects those two icons is that they represent something. The religious icon represents the religion that you follow, and the little thing that you click on your computer represents the area that you want to go to. And so with this word iconic as an adjective, what we mean is that something represents a certain era, a certain idea. And so in the headline here, it's saying that the portrait of Marilyn Monroe is iconic because it represents that whole pop art era.
Mm. And I read in the news recently about Maradona and a special T-shirt, an iconic T-shirt that was sold.
That's right, yeah. Maradona, one of the world's most famous and greatest footballers of all time. The shirt he wore during a World Cup match in the 1980s, in which he scored one absolutely amazing goal, one of the best goals ever, and one goal where he used his hand. It's an iconic shirt because it represents the two sides of Maradona's genius.
Mm. And I don't know about you, but back in the 1990s, I was a big fan of the Spice Girls. They were an iconic pop band from that era, weren't they?
That's right, yes. You can imagine a picture of the Spice Girls with their individual looks. They are iconic. They represent what it was like in the 1990s.
Yeah, okay, great. Well, let's have a summary now of that word. Okay, talking of iconic, the Great Barrier Reef symbolizes the beauty and also the fragile nature of Earth's beauty. And we talked about that on News Review, didn't we, Neil?
We did. And all you have to do to learn all the vocabulary in that program is click the link below.
Okay, let's move on now to your next headline, please.
Yeah, the next headline comes from RTE, which is from Ireland. And it is iconic Warhol portrait of Marilyn Monroe fetches record $195 million.
That's fetches, sells for a certain amount of money.
Yeah. Now, fetches, the verb fetch is an old English word, and it's got a sense of going somewhere to get something. And there's an old nursery rhyme, isn't there, Rob?
Ah, yeah, you're thinking of Jack and Jill. Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water.
Yeah, to fetch a pail of water, to go up the hill and get it and bring it back. And we use this word, it's pretty informal, to mean go and get me something, often used with me. So, Rob, could you go and fetch me a coffee, please, for example?
Okay, a good example. I'm not going to do it now. But here, fetches in the headline, we're not talking about physically getting something. It's more to do with getting a price.
That's right. But you gave away the key there, Rob, getting a price. So it's a different kind of usage here. We're talking about something attracting a certain price, usually in an auction. But the thing that connects it to the other meaning of fetch, going to get, is obtaining, getting something. We don't use this when we're talking about things with fixed prices, sorry. We talk about it, we use it when we're talking about usually auctions. Now, Rob, you had an old bike that you sold recently, didn't you, on one of those online auction sites?
Yes, I did. It's quite a special bike, actually. And amazingly, it fetched a very good price. It fetched a higher price than the one I originally paid for it. So I was quite pleased about that.
Lucky you, Rob.
Right. Shall we fetch some examples now?
Good idea. Let's have a summary.
Are you interested in money and lifestyle? Well, we have a 6-minute English program all about that. How can people watch it, Neil?
Who doesn't like money and lifestyle? All the people need to do is click below.
Yeah, just click down there. And now, Neil, could we have your next headline, please?
Yes, we have a headline from thewire.in from India, and it is, why Andy Warhol's Marilyn Monroe portraits continue to enthrall.
That's enthrall. Keep your attention. Be extremely exciting.
Yes, it's a lovely word, enthrall, enthrall. And we're not just talking about ordinary levels of excitement, are we, Rob?
No, this is about something that is very, very exciting and it captures your attention. So you can't think about anything else. You're really hooked on this thing that you're watching or reading.
Yeah, so we're talking about really exciting sporting events, for example, where you just cannot take your eyes off it. Films, TV series. You've been watching Squid Game, is that right, Rob?
Indeed, yes. The Squid Games, what a brilliant series. I was enthralled. I just couldn't take my eyes off the TV. I wanted to watch the next episode. And it took my mind off other things as well. So I found it very enthralling. And as I say, I was enthralled.
Okay, so you've used two different versions there of an adjective. We have the verb to enthrall, but you said enthralled, and also it was enthralling. And that's how we describe these things that totally take our attention and excite us.
A bit like news review, I hope.
Absolutely, the definition of enthralling.
Okay, let's have a summary. Okay, it's time now to recap the vocabulary we've discussed today, please, Neil.
Yes, we had iconic, very famous, represents an idea, fetches, sells for a certain amount of money, and enthrall, keep your total attention, be extremely exciting.
Okay, if you want to test your understanding of those words, we have a quiz on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. And that's a good place to go to for lots of other learning English resources. And don't forget to check us out on social media as well. Right, well, that's the end of News Review for today. Thanks so much for watching and we'll see you next time. Goodbye.
Goodbye.